In this video, I'm going to build a 3D printer filament spooling machine. There was a shortage of white PLA filament recently, so you could only buy 3 kilo spools. I figured it'd be a fun project to build a machine to respool onto smaller spools, so thought I'd give it a go.
So here's the first test. I haven't cut down the axle yet. It's a piece of an old printer. But it all seems to be working okay. Cogs are meshing well. Parts fit together.
The motor is probably too small, but it's got a built-in gearbox to give it more torque. I made the motor mount separate and adjustable so we can switch in different motors if we need to. For the power source, I used a mobile phone power bank. I like these because they're super portable and it's dead easy to work with 5 volts. For the gears, I found the hardware guy on YouTube has a great video on how to create gear cogs in Fusion 360. So I went for a double helical gears, which mesh together quite nicely, and they were really well. Also added the switch, which is essential for control, so you can turn it off if it goes crazy. The next test was with string to prove it's looking okay, and if things go wrong, you don't have filament flying everywhere. I printed the spool roller for the 3 kilo spool, but it looks like the combo might have too much friction. Anyway, we'll give it a try. Okay, here we go. The moment of truth. Yeah, shall I reach? Okay. Use the piece of tape to secure the end. It was a slow first run, which is not a bad thing when you're testing. You don't want things getting too crazy. I just used my hand to guide the filament onto the new spool, which seemed to work okay. So the major problem is this guy here. He's so big and heavy, he's got too much friction, so I have to manually force it around to give it extra pull. It'd be better if we had a more powerful motor up there. So I've shifted over from the trolley type spool holder, which worked pretty well, but it has a lot of friction, and created this guy here. And the result is like virtually no friction. It's kind of scary how free it is actually. It works really well. The layout of the filaments on the new spool wasn't perfect, but it was tight enough to prevent any snags or jams when printing. The next thing I learned was that as the spool fills up, you need even more torque to drive the spool around. So I changed out the spool cog to be a bit bigger and run slower, but that gave it more torque, which worked pretty good. Now the big moment, end of spool one. Let's chop it. That's done. You can see the winding's not perfect, but it's pretty good. It weighs a bit, so let's actually weigh it and see how much filaments we actually got on this spool. I took off 250 grams for the spool, and it came out to 1100 grams, which is pretty good. For the next run on spool 2, I put a base on the source spool holder and got stuck into it. Here's a time lapse of the spooling. Overall, it took about 15 minutes. Alright, I think we'll stop there. Oh, feels fairly tight, fairly compact. It's pretty good. Alright, spool number 2. Let's weigh it in. So an empty spool weighs 250 grams. Let's see how much this one weighs. If we can balance it there. That's about, what, 1140-ish grams. So this must be about 900 grams. It's not too bad. Cool, and it's pretty dense. Fairly happy with that. So one thing I will do is put it in the dryer for 4 or 5 hours before I put it away in the vacuum bags. That way it'll just heat it and make sure there's no moisture in the filament. Super important, because we don't want the thing going brittle on us. So in conclusion, I think it was a good first version, and the machine was a lot less stressful than using a drill. It goes a bit slower, but it gives you more control. I don't think it's worth respooling like this to save money by buying filament in bulk and respooling, but I think it's useful for splicing nearly depleted spools onto new spools. It'll avoid that "is there enough filament on the spool" mystery. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you for the next version of the Respooler. Please like and subscribe.